We're celebrating Intel's 14th generation core CPUs, and we're doing it in a big way with an epic custom PC giveaway. Not to mention, we're gonna tell you all about the 14700K, what we saw in performance and thermals, and how you can build a sweet custom PC if you don't win. Come on, I hope you win. Plus, a few special somethings along the way. Let's get started. We've got the all new 14th generation Raptor Lake Refresh CPUs right here at Robey. These aren't the right ones. No, we're gonna talk about this one right here, the Intel 14700K. And thanks to our friends at Intel and Newegg, we're gonna build with it, benchmark it, and talk about what makes it special, and give you some resources to help you build a killer rig like the one we're about to show you. It's like an all-inclusive resort, except no spa, no food, no swanky room. Okay, maybe it's not like a resort, but it is all inclusive. Oh yeah, and did I mention that we're gonna give this build away? Sure I did, but you know what? It's worth mentioning again. Let's show you the build. Call it a revamp, a remake, or 13th gen part 2 electric boogaloo, Intel's 14th gen CPUs represent a continued refinement of Intel's hybrid architecture that they introduced with the 12th gen Alder Lake CPUs. Intel has dubbed 14th gen a Raptor Lake refresh, and for a very good reason. It expands on the amazing foundation of power and performance we saw in 13th gen Raptor Lake while kicking its feature set up a notch. These features include compatibility for Wi-Fi 7, which improves latency, signal strength, and supports speeds up to 5 gigabytes, as well as the addition of Thunderbolt 5 support, which will be double the bandwidth of Thunderbolt 4. But you know what, that's not all. Intel's 14th gen CPUs offer increased overclocking frequencies for E cores and P cores, have XMP speeds blazing beyond 8,000 megatransfers, and per core thermal throttling to keep any troublemakers from ruining the whole overclocking party. Now I know all you enthusiast overclockers just perked up a bit, so lean in because this is pretty awesome. There is a feature that is currently being tested on 14th gen Core i9s, a one-click AI performance overclocking called AI Assist. It's like having HAL or Skynet help you overclock, but they aren't gonna try and kill you, they're actually gonna try and help you. Oh, and they're not sentient, I promise. This new feature in Intel's Extreme Tuning Utility analyzes a user's system using advanced machine learning to give your system a true personalized overclock that's perfect for the system you're using. So rather than trying to figure out where your system's sweet spot is and fighting through instability yourself, this feature in 30 seconds gets you to the ballpark where you can start playing with and fine-tuning your overclock yourself. But even if you don't, you just decide you're just gonna leave it alone, you still get an epic overclock and aren't leaving any performance on the table. And a little birdie told me that this feature may just be making its way to other Intel CPUs, like the one we're talking about right here, the Core i7-14700K. So if you're eyeing the system we're showing in this video, which you should be doing because it's epic, this feature should be coming to an XTU near you also. So the Core i7-14700K is a 20-core, 28-thread beast with a turbo max speed of up to 5.6 gigahertz. That's 8 performance or P cores and 12 efficiency or E cores, by the way. In case you haven't looked at the spec sheet recently, which don't worry, this isn't a test, we're gonna break this down. The 14700K has 4 more E cores than the 13700K, 33 megabytes of L3 cache, and 28 megabytes of L2 cache, which, bringing it down, that means 3 more megabytes of L3 and 4 more megabytes of L2 than the 13700K. And it also has a turbo boost max that's about 200 megahertz faster. Now to make this even more interesting, the MSRP for the 14700K was the same as the launch price for the 13700K at $409. You heard that right. They added features, more cores, and fine-tuned goodness all at the same launch price as the 13th gen. Good on Intel for adding features and not increasing the price for this refresh. For you content creators, this is a dream Those added E cores give you even more power to stream, game, and code. And did I mention you could do all of that at the same time? It's techno wizard magic, thanks to the Thread Director and all of those additional cores. Now, it's one thing to talk about it, but let me tell you how we're showcasing the 14700K. Here is the build that we've been showing off since the beginning. To restate the obvious, we're using the new Core i7-14700K for our CPU, and we're gonna cool it with Li & Li's brand new Galahad 2 LCD 360mm AIO liquid cooler in white. It's got that beautiful screen that really helps you add that personal touch everyone wants in their PC build. Continuing inside, another new component, the brand new MSI MPG Z790 Edge TI Max Wi-Fi motherboard, along with MSI's RTX 4070 Ti Gaming X Trio. By using all MSI, we're gonna minimize the amount of RGB programs we need to install and let us use the power for our own nefarious awesome purposes and not random RGB controller programs. Come on, we could take over the world if we have all that ultimate power. We have 32 gigabytes of Patriot Viper DDR5 running at 7,000 megatransfers. We also have a couple more parts from Patriot, thanks to them. Two Viper VP4300 light NVMe drives, a 1 terabyte drive for our system, and 4 terabytes for game storage. This rig is also powered by MSI's MPG A850G 850-watt PSU. It has 7 of Li & Li's SL120 Infinity fans in white, custom cables from Cable Mod, by the way, they look so good, and it's all inside of the clean Fantex P600S PC case. Now, just remember, it does give us these epic covers for silent running, but if you're gonna be doing some epic workloads, make sure that you take these off to give your system the room to breathe. Now, if that wasn't enough, if all those parts weren't epic enough, this system features a sandblasted Intel logo and vinyl decals designed by our friend Ron Lee Christensen at Blue Horse Studios. This dude does some killer mod work. And just like we like to demystify the process of PC building, Ron likes to demystify the process of case modding. So if you want to build this rig yourself, you didn't win it, I'm sorry, we only have one to give away. We're gonna be having links to all the parts down below, as well as the vinyls that you need that you can download and do all of this customization yourself. This powerhouse of a build comes out to just at $3,000, and it really is gonna give us a good picture of what the new Core i7 can do. Enough, enough, enough about the outside. Let's jump in and let's talk about the meat and potatoes. Let's talk about performance. But before I go into this, this isn't gonna be one of those comparing CPU things. In this video, we just wanted to show what a PC built around the 14700K could do. Can we just enjoy this moment together? Is that okay? Good. Let's jump in. For all of our tests, we're running at 1440p, which means any super sampling software we're gonna use, depending on the game, is going to be set to balance. Let's start with Cyberpunk 2077. With ray tracing set to ultra, DLSS and frame generation on, we saw an average frame rate of 149.98 FPS. Not bad to kick it off that way. In Forza Horizon 5, with settings on extreme, also with DLSS and frame generation on, we saw an average of 204 frames per second. For Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the highest settings and DLSS on, we saw averages of 262 frames per second. Now, there is actually a far more interesting story here. And this is one of the two places I'm going to draw a comparison between what we saw with the 14700K in doing some extra heavy lifting here. We tested a similar system recently with the 13700K, and that run, the system with the 13.7 was running GPU bound at 36%. In the system with the 14700K, it's running GPU bound at 49%. Like, listen, we're not calling the 13700K a slouch at all. It's an amazing processor. We're just saying that the 14700K came to work. Okay, so let's go back to the numbers. In Tiny Tina's Wonderland, with FSR on and settings bumped up to badass, our rig pushed 204.5 frames per second. Now, moving on to Modern Warfare 2, with presets turned down to minimum, again, setting things for competitive, we got 211 frames per second. And we did the same thing with Apex Legends and Fortnite also. At low visual settings, again, optimizing for competitive, we saw 292.6 in Apex Legends, and on Fortnite, we saw 477.2. I mean, that means it's like pretty much, Brian, it's pretty much unplayable at that point in time. I mean, why even bother? Now, the gaming metrics are great, but when you start looking at the details, the 14700K is capable of so much more. And you're probably wondering, Robey, what is that second thing you were gonna comment on? When we looked at the power draw, both maximum and averages, the 14700K used 10 watts less on average and up to 50 watts less at max draw than the 13700K during our gaming tests and at idle. It did draw about 30 watts more under CPU low, but that isn't terribly surprising considering the 14700K is powering four more E-cores. And with these extra E-cores, plus enhanced cache and faster clock speeds, the 14700K is even better at megatasking. What is megatasking? Well, let's start with this. We saw this in 13th gen, just how good it was at multi-core and multi-threaded tasks. But with this refresh, users can game, stream, and record clips without fear of huge performance dips. If you want to see how epic this can be, what multitasking can do, then check out the Intel launch stream here and watch the megatasking demo with Aaron from Intel. Overall, the enhancements to the i7-14700K can set the CPU up to be the golden child of this product generation. Seriously, the 13700K was the darling of the last generation, and I guess this has been refreshed to this generation as well. Now, before we wrap this whole thing up in a pretty bow, I do want to answer two burning questions. Question one, should you upgrade to a 14th gen Intel CPU? Honestly, if you've been putting an upgrade off and you're still on something earlier, like 11th gen Intel or an older Ryzen 5000 series, then looking into megatasking and many of the things that we've been talking about with 14th gen could be a huge leap in performance for someone like you. Now, while you might see some steps forward from 12th and 13th gen, we're not sure you would get as much value out of these improvements than you would see from older hardware. I know, we like being on the bleeding edge too. Though, if you're on a 12th gen 12700K, that only has 12 cores. So the leap up to 20 cores, especially as a content creator, may actually be worth it. And you don't even need to change your motherboard. And finally, question number two, how do I win this PC, Robey? Well, down in the description of this video, alongside all of the links to the parts for this build and the decals you need to build this exact machine, there is a giveaway link. Make sure you click on that link and follow the instructions. That's it. Now, we hope you've enjoyed our foray into the world of Intel's 14th gen CPUs. It's not the last you're going to be seeing them around here at Robeytech. We want to give a huge shout out to Intel, Newegg, Bluehorse, MSI, and Patriot for partnering with us to make this build happen. And if you do build this PC, if you follow all the steps, we want to see it. Seriously, tag us on socials, or better yet, join our Discord community, discord.gg/Robeytech, post in the PC pick channels, and make some new PC building friends along the way. But before you leave, make sure you click the link below to enter for your chance to win this amazing PC. And if you would, go ahead, slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here at Robeytech. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.